Hello everyone. So now we are going to see about the pumping lemma. So it is one of the property mainly used to check whether the given language is regular or not regular. So first you have to know the difference between regular and not regular. So regular means it is always finite, not regular means it is always infinite. So finite means if you have a countable number of string means that is finite, uncountable means that is infinite. For example, for taking 0 power n as a language where n is less than or equal to 2 means you have only two possibilities. N is equal to 1 or 2 only, so 0 power 1, 0 power 2. So this kind of languages are regular. In the next side we have 0 power n where n is greater than 2. So in that case we have it will be more than 2, but there is no upper limit for that. So 3, 4 up to infinity. So this kind of language is called the not regular. So we are using the proof by contradiction property to prove the language is regular or not regular. So in order to use the pumping lemma, we have to know the three conditions. So first condition is x, y power I, z belongs to that given language. Second one is the length of y should be greater than 0. And third one, length of xy should be less than or equal to p. So p is a pumping length, we can see it in the problem. So we have a three condition. If any one condition fails among these three condition, we can say that given language is not regular. So take an example. I am taking the example a is equal to 0 power n, 1 power n, where n is greater than 0. So you have to prove language is not regular. So the given string is 0 power n, 1 power n means if you are having a 3 number of zeros, it should be followed by a 3 number of 1s. Number of zeros and number of 1 in the language should be equal and also in the same order. That is the given problem. So I already told we are using the property, contradiction property. So in the given language it is not regular, I am taking assume a is regular. So if it is regular, it should have some finite length only. So I am taking that length of the string should be 3 for that n value. So 0 power 3, 1 power 3. So my value is 0001. So first step is we have to split the assigned string into 3 parts, x, y, z. So you can split it in any way, but it should have 3 parts. So I am taking 00 as x, 01 as y, 11 as z. So our first condition is x, y power I, z belongs to that language. So suppose I am that I represents, you can take any value for the I from 0 to whatever value it is. So after substituting the value for I, the string should be in that language. Then only the condition will succeed. So I am taking I is equal to 3. So the string will be x, y power 3, z. So we have to substitute the y value for 3 times. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So now we have some 5 number of zeros, 5 number of 1s, but it is not in the correct order. Our given question is if we have 4 number of zeros, then 4 number of 1s should be followed. But in that case, 0 and 1 are interchanged. So it does not belong to our language, therefore condition 1 fails. So condition 2 is length of y should be greater than 0. In all the cases, condition 2 gets succeed because it should have at least length 1 for y value. So our length of the y is 6 in that string, so 6 is greater than 0, so condition 2 succeed. So condition 3 is length of x y should be less than or equal to p. So p is nothing but the pumping length. So whatever the value we assume in the initial stage, that is the pumping length. I am assuming p is equal to 3. So length of the x y in the sense, length of the x is 0, 0, length of y is I have 16. So length of the x y is 8. So 8 is less than or equal to 3 means that condition failed. So if any one condition fail among these three condition, then we can say that given language is not regular. So that is the pumping lemma. It's one of the property used to check whether the language is regular or not regular. For this, we are using the property called proof by contradiction. We can solve this easily. Thank you.